Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna do a get ready with me because I'm going out with my boyfriend and the rest of my family to one of the events in my uncle's distillery. I'll leave all the information down below for the distillery. If you're from New York, it's located in the Bronx. So what my uncle does is he makes pitorro, which is moonshine, Puerto Rican moonshine. And it's actually, I think it's still illegal in Puerto Rico, but he made it here. And I think he's the only person in the States that does it, or one of the only people in the States that does it. And it's so good. They have a bunch of different flavors. He has the whole distillery in the Bronx and it's amazing. And they're getting noticed by like a lot of high profile people. And today they're gonna be featured on Viceland on a show called Hustle. So yes, we're gonna go out and I just wanna look my best because there's gonna be pictures and all that stuff. So yeah. Today I'm also gonna be trying out the new L'Oreal Infallible 24-hour fresh wear foundation. I know I'm a little late to this because a lot of people have reviewed it, but I wanted to try it for myself because I love the original Infallible foundation, the Pro Matte. You've seen me use it on the channel already, and I love it. It's like my holy grail drugstore foundation. So first, I always start off with my eyebrows with the NYX Microbrow Pencil in Espresso, as usual. I already primed my eyelids with concealer that I use to carve out my brows. So the eye that I want to do today is pretty simple. I have it in my head, and I'm gonna use the Juvia's Place The Warrior 2 palette. But first, I'm gonna go with the shade Kana. It's this beautiful, like taupey, grayish, nudey color. And I'm just gonna put that all over my lids with a flat brush, and I'm gonna stay away from the brow bone because I want to highlight that with the white shade in the palette. And I'm gonna go in with this BH Cosmetics brush. It's a little angled, but it's not super thin. It's a little fluffy. So I'm gonna take the color Kufuru. First, I'm gonna put it on like kind of perfect. And then start blending it upwards. And I actually just missed a very important step, but I'll do it after. And if it starts getting thicker towards the ends over here, outer corners, it's okay because we're gonna smoke that out. Now I'm gonna smoke out the outer V's, and I'm going to go in with Kana and Yodit. I can't even pronounce these things right. First of all, it's like deleting what I just did with my liner. I'm gonna put a little bit in the crease too. Why not? Why not? So now I'm gonna go in with that first brown shade that I used on my faux liner and a little bit of Wazana. It's like a, I don't know what to call it, like a charcoal brown black. And smooth out the outer V a little bit more. To highlight my brow bone, I'm gonna use the bone shade inside the palette. It's called Zazz. And I kind of drag it down a little bit, almost to like where the crease is, so it doesn't look so blotchy. I'm gonna go back in with that angled fluffy brush, and I'm gonna take the black shade in the palette, and then I'm going to fake the liner a little bit more, like make it more smoky. I'm gonna take this tiny little flat brush and a little bit of that bone shade, and I'm going to place it in the middle of my eyelid. And I'm gonna put it in my inner corner. So now we're gonna move on to the face. I'm gonna use the Benefit Professional because lately my pores have been looking a little enlarged. I'm gonna put that much on the sides of my nose, on my nose, the forehead, here, and here. Kind of just dab a little bit everywhere. Don't worry about my brows right now. I know they look a little funky, but I'm gonna change. Not change, I'm gonna fix them. I'm gonna change them. Because I'm expecting the Infallible to be like medium coverage, maybe full coverage. I'm going to use the Glam Glow Glow Starter Mega Illuminating Moisturizer in Nude Glow just to give me an underneath glow because it might be like super matte and I don't want it to be super matte today. So I'm gonna take like that much. It smells so good. And just to be extra, I'm gonna use the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Liquid. I'm just gonna put like a third of a pump on my finger. I'm gonna put it here. Oh, you see? Mm-hmm. Let me put it everywhere, like the other one. And last thing, because I want my foundation to go on super smooth, I'm gonna use the Dior Capture R Flash Instant Ultra Smoothing Fluid. And I always use this on myself when I want to look like super like smooth and on my clients. Finally, on to the foundation. I don't know what shade this is. It might be too light. If it's too light, I'm gonna have to bronze up my face a whole lot. So I'm gonna put a pump. Take my damn beauty sponge, beauty blender, and let's see. It doesn't feel like super thick. It's actually a little runny. This is like my trouble side. For some reason, like when I'm stressed, I only break out on this side. I don't know if you could tell, but I break out on this side and this side is like just peachy. It's definitely lightweight. I don't feel it at all on my face. I'm gonna go do the other side. So my camera's off because it said that the, the camera was too hot and it needed to cool down. Stupid. Anyways, I blended it all out. I did like another pump just to get a little bit more coverage. It's like a medium coverage foundation, definitely. And it looks really soft. I can still see some glow under. And it looks really pretty. The color, that's actually not that off for me. It's a little, It's weird, I can't go by my hands because my hands sometimes are darker than my face and sometimes they're lighter than my face. So, but it goes to my neck. So let's do some cream contour. I'm gonna use my Pro Concealer in Fawn. I don't even like cream contour, but lately I've been loving it. Put too much on this side. I have a little panic attack because it's a little dark. And then with whatever's left again, I just go around my jaw. So for concealer, I'm gonna use two different ones. Same brand, the LA Girl Pro Conceal. Concealers, did I just like flip them upside down? That's beautiful, right? I'm gonna use natural first underneath, and then on top, I'm going to use the yellow corrector. So the pinky natural one is gonna counteract the dark circles, and then once that's concealed, then I'm gonna put the yellow one on top just to brighten. Beauty blender, and I want the eyeshadow to look kind of like straight this way up, so I'm just gonna press like kind of make like an imaginary diagonal line going up like this. So if you messed up on your eyeshadow and you made it like come down a little weird there, that's a little technique. And now I'm just gonna put a little bit of the yellow corrector right on top of that just to help brighten. And I'm only gonna put a little bit because I don't want it to look cakey, because lately my under eyes have been looking a little thick. And before I blend that out, I'm going to use my Benai Neutral Set Colorless Powder. And I'm just gonna put it on the back of a palette. Like that. Like that. And I just prepped the powder just because when I'm blending out my concealer, so it doesn't crease so fast, I take out the powder and I lay it out. So that as soon as I'm done with the concealer and blending it out, I can just set it. And now immediately I go in with the powder. I'm excited about tonight, but it won't be tonight for you guys when you see this. This is gonna be like 2 days after, 3 days after. By the time I get to edit, it's gonna be days after. Oh, I just popped off my ear. Just to chisel out my cheekbones a little bit, I'm gonna take my beauty blender with the neutral set powder again, and I'm just gonna trace a little line. So it's a little sharper. But I'm not gonna leave it on for too long because I don't want it to be super sharp. And I'm just gonna wipe this away. I only left it on for about 2 minutes. Because of the concealer, my under eye circles are gone. Disappeared. I'm gonna smoke out my lower lash line. I'm gonna take Kana and just run her under my lash line. And I'm gonna keep extending this way. And then with the angled fluffy brush thing, I'm gonna take that charcoal brown black color and run it a little closer to my lashes. For lashes, I'm gonna use Dodo Lashes in D119. They're a little cat eye and fluffy, so I love them. And I think it goes best with these eyes because there's a lot more like smokiness going on towards the ends, like the outer V's. So I feel like the lashes, since they're cat eye, they're gonna accentuate all that. To bronze up my face, I'm gonna use the MAC NC43 and I'm gonna use my e.l.f. Angled Blush Brush. This is like my dynamic duo. Just gonna add a little bit to my cream contour. And I'm gonna add a little bit of this powder down here because I don't like when you reverse contour, it looks a little white if I don't like it. I'm just gonna add a little bit of color. Oh my god, that looks so beautiful! For a blush, I'm gonna use the Juvia's Place, the Saharan Blush Palette Volume 2, and I'm gonna take the color B. It's like a purpley, burgundy, cool color. I don't know how to explain it, but it's really nice, and it goes, I think, perfectly with my eyeshadow. I'm gonna put a little bit on my brush, and then I'm gonna tap off the excess, because this blush is super pigmented. And I kind of like to swirl it into the contour color, just so it melts together. For mascara, I'm gonna use the Maybelline Falsies on my bottom lashes. Hopefully I don't hit my cheek, because I always do. And I'm gonna put a little bit of mascara on the lashes and mine, because I forgot to prep them. Going on in the side. Okay, there we go. Okay, for highlight, I'm gonna use an oldie. What does they say? What do people say? Goldie? Oldie but a goldie? Oldie? I don't fucking give a fuck. I'm gonna use Mary Luminizer from The Balm on my Morphe M501, my favorite brush. I'm just gonna go like this, like that. Ooh, that's too much. Oh, yep, that's exactly what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. That's right, Mary Lou. That's right, Mary Lou. She's like top five. Woo! Good. And just a little bit on down the bridge of my nose, or a lot. I'm gonna make everything really highlighted and dewy just because my eyes are matte. For lip liner, I'm gonna use the NYX lip liner in nude beige. You can't even see the color, but it's like a nudie and it's like a little warmer. It's not like, I mean, a little cooler. It's not like a warm nude, it's like a cool nude. To make my lips appear a little bit more pouty in the middle, I'm gonna use the Wet n Wild Liquid Katsu in, let's see, Nudie Patootie. I think I used it in one of my last videos. I'm just gonna pop this right in the middle. I'm gonna go back in with the lip liner and just line my lips a little bit more. I'm gonna use a MAC lipstick. I think it was from like a holiday collection. It's called I'm Glistening. The packaging looks like this. It's so beautiful. It's like a taupey, crystally color. It actually just darkened up my lips. That's great. Not what I wanted. But I'm not mad at it. It looks really cute. I like them about this. Do I want this? So that is it for the face. I just fixed my brows off camera. I added more highlight, I added more bronzer. So right now I'm gonna do my hair really quick because I can't be in the shoots looking like this. I'm crazy, my hair's gotten so long. So I just take a comb and I go down the middle. I'm gonna get some gel. Dip a little bit underneath here. Take my hairbrush and just brush it back. I'm gonna put this in a bun. I'm not gonna make this. This looks crazy. Make sure you don't have any hair sticking out. And that's my easy hairstyle. That was cute. With anything you put on, you can stick it out. I'm just gonna set my eyebrows really quick with the Essence Make Me Brow. I'm gonna spray my face with the Too Faced Hangover RX 3-in-1 Replenishing Primer and Setting Spray so that it doesn't look as powdery on my face. And to finish setting my makeup officially, I'm gonna use the NYX Matte Finish Long Lasting Setting Spray. And right before it's about to dry, when it's still a little wet, I'm gonna add a little bit more highlight to intensify. So that is all for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. And if you wanna see me make more videos, just subscribe and give me a thumbs up. If you guys have any suggestions on videos that I should make, just comment below or comment on my Instagram pictures. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.